Praise the Lord, my dear friends in the Lord. Today's readings reveal to us this secret. Look unto the Lord, and your face will begin to shine, and you will never be put to shame. The Psalm 34, verse 5. The Lord teaches us, if you look unto the Lord, you will look beyond yourself. When you look unto the Lord, the Lord's light will shine on you. You will know who are you, what is the brightness to which you belong to, and you will begin to do the things beyond yourself, the actions, the way you live will be a blessing for many, and you will never be put to shame. Yes, look unto the Lord, and you will look beyond yourself, is the message of the readings of today. Look unto the Lord, and you will look beyond yourself. In today's first reading, St. Paul, in the fourth chapter of his epistle, first letter, he says that the Father saw us dying in our sin, and seeing our pathetic situation, with love, he sent his only Son for us. He saw us dying in sin, and he did something beyond just to feel sorry for our sin. He sent his only Son to die on the cross, to shed his blood for us, because he saw things beyond ourselves. If we live in sin, we will die in our sin. The ruler of the sin will destroy us. Our life will become a destroyed life. He saw beyond our pain. He saw beyond our struggle. So he sent his Son to wipe away all our sin. And he rejoiced in sacrificing the best of himself for us. Yes. In the gospel of today, we find in Mark's gospel, chapter 6, when Jesus saw the people coming to him, his look went beyond himself. Yes, he saw them like the sheep without the shepherd. Yes, his look teaches us something beyond. When he saw people, he saw their hearts. When he saw their eyes, he saw their pain. And he thought over, what can I do for them? How can I relieve their pain? Jesus looked unto us, and he went beyond us. He went beyond himself, and he stood giving them the word of God and healing everyone who came to him. He healed all of them. He went beyond himself to give all that they were looking for. That's why we read in 1 Chronicle chapter 16 verse 7 that like the bird hovers around the earth, the eyes of the Lord are looking towards us. He sees our pain. He sees our struggle. And then he gives everything of himself for us. No wonder he gave his own blood on the cross, the best of his for our sake, that we may understand love. What is love? How much we have loved from God? Who are we? If he did not die on the cross, what would have been our fate? Yes. And once we recognize his love, we become people of lovable beings. And that is the purpose of God's love for us, that we to become persons of love like him to this loveless, broken, disturbed world. We go beyond ourselves. We go beyond our pain. We go beyond our sacrifice to stand with the broken people, disturbed, sick world, dark world, and give the love of God's light, God's compassion, God's mercy, God's forgiveness, and God's love. My dear friends, when he saw the crowd, they were like sheep without the shepherd for Jesus. If a sheep doesn't have a shepherd, the sheep will not know where to go. What are the difficulties it is going to face? What are the enemies, lions and tigers coming behind? And where to eat? Where is the water? Nothing. It will soon be destroyed. Yes, without God, we can't survive anymore. Jesus said, you can do nothing without me. John 15:5. And here Jesus went beyond himself and he preached them. And at the end, he gave them all the food that is needed for them. Because the way man looks is different. The disciples saw them as a problem. Oh, it is getting dark. Send them away. But Jesus saw them something different way from the disciples. The disciples saw the problems. The master saw the solution. The disciples saw them a burden, and we need to get out of the problem. Most of the time people think others and life as a problem, and the goal of life is to get out of problem. But Jesus saw what he has, the power he has, the love he has, and the love which gives the power to destroy every evil, and the power of love that supplies everything that is needed for the humanity. He saw Father's love in himself, and he gave it in full. Maybe check our own life and the way we look at ourselves and others. If we look unto God, we will look beyond ourselves. We see how God loves us and what is the price he paid for us. If we look unto the Lord, we will become persons of love, and we will become like Master. We will also go beyond ourselves to see the problem and pain of others. We will not try to run away from others. Let any amount of problem come on our way. What will the problems do to us? Will they kill us? No. Every problem also comes with a cry that somebody is in trouble. Somebody is in pain. Somebody is in dissatisfaction. Somebody is in need of help. And it is up to us to go beyond ourselves and to participate in those struggle and pain and be a blessing. God has loved us. May we become persons of love. Let's look beyond ourselves, and may this world be blessed by us. All that God has is you and me. Let we be his wonderful witness on this earth. Amen.